Fancy Girl Jackie, and I'm so excited to talk to you guys about the product I'm reviewing today. So today we're going to be talking about the brand new Escada fragrance called Born in Paradise, and I am obsessed with the Escada summer fragrances. I've been for years. Those of you guys who've been subscribed for a really long time know that as soon as Escada puts out their, what the hell is going on with my hair right here? Okay, hang on, stand by. So I pretty much every year wait for the Escada fragrances to come out. Their summer fragrances are hands down my favorite fragrances of all time. I'm obsessed with perfume, I'm obsessed with fragrance, so for me to say that, it really means something because I buy a lot of perfume. So every year around like late February, early March, I start checking the Escada site to see like if they posted anything about the new summer fragrance yet. And as soon as I see it, I go out and buy it like the second I can. This time was no different. So it's called Born in Paradise, as the description says. So since I like to be really detailed with my fragrance reviews, I'm gonna tell you guys about the fragrance, I'm gonna tell you guys about the scent, I'm going to tell you all the top and bottom notes and all the really important information you need before deciding to buy this, just because this is a luxury fragrance and it is expensive. I believe I paid $56 for this, and this is the 1.6 fluid ounce size. So it is a luxury product. In my opinion, it is absolutely worth it. I am going to rave about it pretty much right now and tell you why I think it's so fabulous. But I want you guys to have all the information too before you spend the money. I spent it knowing that I was going to like the fragrance, so I didn't mind, but it is a lot of money to spend if it's something you're not too sure on. I'm gonna start by telling you guys about the packaging, which is gorgeous. I'm not surprised. Escada always delivers with the packaging. Look at how beautiful that is. It is very tropical. It is very paradise-like. And I'll just show you guys the whole box because it's really, really pretty. And a lot of people tend not to care about packaging because you're like, well, I want the perfume to be good. I don't care what the packaging looks like. But in my opinion, if I'm gonna spend this much on a fragrance, I want every single detail to be perfect. Because I'm giving you a lot of my hard-earned money for this. I want the packaging perfect, I want the scent perfect, I want the bottle perfect, okay? You better make it perfect if you want my money. That's how I feel, and Escada always delivers. So now let's open the box. So this is the bottle, and this is very traditional in terms of what the Escada summer fragrance bottles look like. They always have the same shape and the same cap, and the past couple years they've also come with this little decorative thing on top, and this looks like just a little decoration, but it is a little bonus because it is actually a little ring. Oh, for crying out loud, not adorable. So it's a little tropical flower ring. I like to keep mine on the bottle because I feel like it's really decorative and it looks really pretty. And then on the back of the bottle, we also have this really cute little drawing of a parrot. Really pretty. So let's get into the important part, which is what the fragrance smells like. So before I get into the top and bottom notes, I'm just gonna tell you that it smells like the most delicious, fruity, tropical drink you've ever imagined in your life. The difference being it's not sugary, which is one thing I really like about Escada scents. They tend to be very fresh, very clean, and very fruity, but they achieve the fruity scent without being sugary, which I really hate. I don't wanna walk around smelling like a daiquiri or like a drink that should have an umbrella in it. I'm a human, I'm not a drink with an umbrella in it, okay? So I don't wanna smell too sweet. I wanna smell fruity without smelling like a drink that's gonna get you wasted and passed out on the sidewalk. That may or may not have actually happened. You know, that's what I really like about these scents, is they achieve that type of scent without doing it in a cheap way. Like a lot of the cheap body sprays and stuff like that make you smell like candy, and I don't really like that. I want to smell elegant, but still, fresh and fruity. So let me just read the top notes and the base notes for you guys. Like I said, the scent is very tropical. It is very fruity. So the top notes are green apple, guava, and watermelon. I personally really smell all three of them. Usually one stands out more than the other, but it just smells like a really good mix of the three. It's actually like a perfect blend. Cause when I read that it was green apple, I was a little bit nervous cause I was like, oh, what if it smells like green apple puckers, or you know, that drink, I hate green apple puckers. Okay. I had that on my 21st birthday. It did not end well. All right. So I was really afraid I would smell like that, but it actually is a really perfect combination. So those are the top notes. The heart notes are pineapple, coconut milk, and jasmine tea. And the coconut milk, I really pick up a lot here, and I think that's what helps mellow out the sweetness, because it's not a sweet coconut. It is just a like an essence of coconut, if you will. So the base notes are sandalwood, cedarwood, and musk. So they kind of threw me off a little bit when I read that. I was like, oh God, please don't let this be the first one that I don't like, because I really, really do not like sandalwood. I've never liked sandalwood. Sandalwood to me really stinks. I don't like cedarwood either, and I hate musk. So when I read that those were the base notes, I was like, oh my God, this is gonna be horrible. It's gonna be the first one I don't like. Oh my God, I'm gonna end up in therapy. What am I gonna do? And actually, I barely pick up on those at all. And I think, again, that is part of what helps mellow out the sweet fruitiness of the scent. So before I get into all the size and pricing information, all that good stuff, I will tell you the one issue I do have with this, and it is an issue that I have with all the other Escada fragrances, is it doesn't last very long. It is the type of thing where I spray it on in the morning, and like around 3 or 4 in the afternoon, I have to refresh it if I still wanna keep the scent on, which I'm actually due for a little refresher right now, excuse me. I do wish that these scents would last a little bit longer, but I feel like they would have to accomplish that by adding other ingredients that might alter the smell in some way, and that they might not smell as good. So I'm willing to sacrifice that, but it is an issue. So if you want something that you only have to apply once a day, this might not be the perfume for you. You don't mind reapplying, totally fine, pick this one up. What am I doing with my hands? It looks like hand puppets. What the hell is wrong with me? So one other important thing about this fragrance, to me, this is absolutely vital, is it does not affect my allergies at all. So it is springtime and I have horrible spring allergies. I live in Northern California and the pollen out here is off the chain come late March and April. And I get very sensitive to fragrances. Like floral fragrances tend to bother me. A lot of fragrances just annoy me and I can't handle them and I get really congested and my eyes get really watery. I can just not tolerate fragrances at all. This one does not bother me in the least bit. It's actually the main reason why I started to wear the Escada Spring and Summer fragrances in the first place, is I tried them out 1 year and they didn't bother my allergies and I was like, oh my God, this is like a miracle. So that is one of my favorite things about these. So if you are sensitive and you have really bad allergies, try this one because it's probably not gonna bother you. The size options, they offer a ton of size options. So even though this is a pricey fragrance, you can always get the smaller size. They offer the rollerball size, which is only $20, and I'm probably gonna buy the rollerball size. Also because I really love to have that in my purse. I always have whatever fragrance it is that I'm wearing in my purse in case I need to touch up. And the rollerball is perfect because I kinda hate having the bottles in my purse because they open and they spill. And it's really awful and you know your purse stinks and the whole deal. So they do have the rollerball size, and it's also perfect if you wanted to try it out without committing to a $60 bottle of perfume. So they also offer a 1 ounce size, and this is what that looks like. This is a different scent, but as you can see, this is the 1.6. This is the 1 ounce. So the 1 ounce size is $45, and that one's kind of like not that good of a value to me. I feel like if you're gonna get one, the 1.6 is a much better value, and that one is $59, and that's the one I have right here. And I'll be honest with you, the only reason why I didn't buy the larger size is because they didn't have it in stock and I didn't want to wait. I wanted to get the perfume right away. I'm so impatient. And it really doesn't matter because I'm probably going to be completely done with this bottle by June, and then I'll buy the bigger bottle, so it's totally fine for me. So they also offer a 3.3 ounce size bottle, and that's this size right here. This again is a different fragrance, but I'm just trying to show you guys the size of bottle so you know the difference. So in this size, it would be $75, which for me is a good value because I use the crap out of these things. This is actually my second bottle in this fragrance. Yeah, I use a lot of it, so for me it's totally worth it. So that is it. I think I've covered everything. If there's anything you guys want to know about the fragrance that I have not covered in this video, please let me know in the comments down below and I will absolutely address it. If it's one thing I try to do with my fragrance reviews, I try to be very informative because again, this is a luxury brand and I want to make sure you guys are informed before you're spending your money. I absolutely give this an A++++. I'm not even surprised. I've come to expect really high quality from Escada, and when it comes to their spring and summer fragrances, I've come to expect really amazing fragrances. This year did not disappoint. I say get it, especially if you like fruity, elegant fragrances. So definitely this is a win for me. This is not going to be in my hated it videos because I love it so much. So I hope you guys enjoyed this review video. Please let me know in the comments down below if you enjoy my fragrance reviews, because I'm constantly buying new fragrances and I love doing the reviews. Also, if there is a fragrance that you like, that you'd like to see a review on, that you think I might enjoy, again, let me know in the comments down below and I will check it out and do a review for you guys. So anyways, thank you guys so much for stopping by to hang out with me in this video, and don't forget to follow me on Twitter and Instagram. All the links are down below, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.